Urban Therapy with Sun752, and this is your daily go-get-em-ism number 435 for December 12th, 2015. Fresh off the heels of another Mind, Right, and Body Better fitness program. It was the bomb today. Y'all see, you know, more of these, more videos from that, you know, when I upload them later on. But I want y'all to check out this song from one of my favorite artists, from one of my favorite groups of all time. And it's a crazy thing about this song. We'll talk about it after we finish playing it. This is, y'all know what it is. Y'all know this song. This is the oldest, definitely the oldest one. Songs, one of the greatest soul classics ever, going back to Georgia. But the thing is, you know what, Midnight Train to Georgia, that was a diss record. She talked about her dude couldn't make it out in California, so he came back home, back to the country, because it was like, all right, well, you know, I tried, I failed, I'm out, you know what I mean, to a simpler place and time. It's crazy, man. You know what I mean? Because we got to keep it going. We can't just bail out like that. We got to, you know what I'm saying? Once you make it out there, you go out to L.A., you can't just bail out. You can't just come home. You know, things will never be the same for you to, you know, after you've experienced what you experienced out there, saw the crazy stuff that goes on out there. You know what I'm saying? But listen, what I wanted to talk to y'all about today is when the cable is still on. Listen, it's Christmas time, and actually about a week and a half, yeah, it's about 2 weeks. It's the 25th, it's the 12th, yeah, and just about 2 weeks. Yo, shut up out there. It's just about 2 weeks. You know what I mean? It's going to be on, and a lot of people are spending a lot of money right now and accumulating bills right now, and those bills are going to come back to bite them in the ass pretty soon. Now, we don't think about that a lot when many of us are feeling the Christmas spirit, I guess you could say. And, you know, shopping to the drop, running up their credit cards, and not really thinking too much about it, because in a short time, it'll be tax return time. So they figure they can recoup all of that and save themselves from debtor's prison once again, right? But, you know, when you think about all your monthly expenses, wouldn't it be great to be able to save more or keep more than you have to pay out? You know, like, whatever amount that you're paying out. Let's say you make over a two-week period. Let's say your take-home pay is something like $1,300. And when you start adding up, calculating your monthly expenses, you know, you're left with about, out of that one check, it might take the whole check. You might have to use one check for bills, and then the other check is money you know, maybe it's to yourself. If you're lucky. If you are a regular person, then you probably have to spend money from both checks. Because when we get overextended, it takes up more money, and we wind up having to to be left with just a little bit of money, but it'd be nice to be able to keep more. A lot of people, in order to make ends meet a little bit more, have cut their cable off. If you think about it, cable is a luxury. A lot of people who get used to cable TV work that bill into their regular bill schedule. But that's one of the hardest bills to get used to. Remember when you first got your cell phone back in the day? It was hard to get used to paying that bill every month. It's the same thing with cable. But we've gotten so used to cable TV that, you know, for those of us who have it, that we don't think twice about writing that check out. And when you think about it, the check that we write out for it is ridiculous. All of these triple play bundles and all of these little offers that they give up, they're not really saving us any money. The average, who do you know who spends less than $100 for whatever bundle of services that they have, whether it's home phone, internet, and cable, or just cable and internet? Who do you know? It's really hard to do it unless you are going to sacrifice the channels that you have. So what a lot of people have done is that they've turned off their cable. They've got their cable turned off, and they've opted to use video services like Netflix, Hulu, Flixster, Amazon Video, and Roku. And there are others. And, you know, some people report that they're pretty satisfied with these services. You know, you just get one of them, get the one that suits your needs the best. Maybe if you like TV shows, Hulu would probably be the better one for you, because they offer a lot of real-time television shows. You just gotta, even if you have Hulu Plus, you gotta sit through these commercials. It's the wackest thing. But nonetheless, you know, you may not have any local TV service where you are. You may not have bought the converter box. So you gotta do what you gotta do. It's not a bad idea, especially if you don't watch a whole lot of network TV. If you just like movies and documentaries and maybe TV shows, but you don't care about watching them in real time, and you like to watch them, you like to binge watch. What I mean by binge watching is that you can take the you can see the entire season the entire season at one time on these video services, instead of having to wait week after week after week and trying to DVR and missing episodes and things like that. So it's a good look, and it's something to consider, because really, if you can afford cable TV, then you really don't have any business complaining about bills, because that is a bill straight up and down, paying for TV upwards of $150, $200. Come on, man. Stop playing. You know what I mean? And I'm not even going to get into the major cable companies, the Comcast, the DirecTV, the Verizon, the Dish Networks, AT&T Universe, Time Warner. It doesn't matter. All of them jerking. All of them are bending you over and giving it to you raw. You know what I'm saying? But it's time for us to take our power back. And the only way for you to take your power back is to educate yourself and start trimming the fat. They are not putting money in your pocket. That old saying, the more you spend, the more you save, that's the stupidest thing I've heard. You know what I mean? The more you spend is the more you don't have to spend anymore. That's how it goes. Good things happen to those who wait. Great things happen to those who grind. And anything can happen to those who go for theirs. So go hard, go for yours. And listen, if you like your cable TV, the advice that I would give to you is to threaten to leave your cable company for another cable company, because then they'll drop down the price. Don't let them scare you in the beginning by them making you think that just because you're in a contract or whatever, that you're going to be paying off, and they don't really care, because they do care. They can't afford to lose customers, not even one. So what will happen is they'll tell you that they're going to bill you that last bill, send you that last bill, whatever, and the next day or so, they will call you and give you the lowest offer available, especially if you've been a loyal customer, because they need that. Sure, they treat the new customers the best, but you become a new customer by threatening to leave their asses. It works. I'm going to holler at y'all tomorrow. I want y'all to have a great night. Be safe for the rest of this weekend. Don't forget about another Mind Right and Body Better fitness program next Saturday. You know what I'm saying? We get it in. Back to you, Gladys, and the Pips. Do it. Superstar, but he didn't get far. But he sure found out the hard way.